Welcome to Doc's Coffee YouTube channel. Today we are going to tell about coagulation cascade and coagulation abnormalities.
Coagulation cascade. It has three pathways: extrinsic pathway, intrinsic pathway, and common pathway. So at first coming to extrinsic pathway. Following damage to the blood vessel, factor 7 leaves the circulation and it comes in contact with the tissue factor, which is expressed on tissue factor bearing cells. Those are stromal fibroblasts and leukocytes. These all forms an activated complex, that is tissue factor, factor 7A complex, which activates factor 10 to factor 10A. From here, common pathway starts. This activated factor 10 along with activated factor 5 activates factor 2 to factor 2A. This activated factor 2 in turn activates factor 1 to factor 1A. Factor 1A is also known as fibrin. Fibrin subunits comes together to form fibrin strands, and factor 13 acts on fibrin strands to form a fibrin mesh. This mesh helps to stabilize the platelet plaque. Then coming to intrinsic pathway. In intrinsic pathway, high molecular weight kininogen kallikrein activates factor 12 to factor 12A. This activated factor 12 activates factor 11 to factor 11A. This activated factor 11 activates factor 9 to factor 9A. This activated factor 9 along with activated factor 8 activates factor 10 to factor 10A, where common pathway continues.
Prothrombin time represents extrinsic pathway. Activated partial thromboplastin time represents intrinsic pathway. Common pathway is represented by both PT and APTT. Prolonged PT is associated with abnormality or deficiency of common pathway factors and extrinsic pathway factors. Those are factor 1, 2, 5, 10, and 7. Prolonged APTT is associated with abnormality or deficiency of common pathway factors and intrinsic pathway factors. Those are factor 1, 2, 5, 10, 8, 9, 11, 12. Congenital afibrinogenemia is deficiency of factor 1, which is involved in common pathway. Hence, both PT and APTT are prolonged. Thrombin time, bleeding time, and platelet count would be normal. Glanzmann's thrombosthenia, there is absence of glycoprotein 2B and 3A, which is present on platelet surface and is essential for platelet aggregation. Since it is absent in Glanzmann's thrombosthenia, bleeding time is prolonged. PT, ABTT, and platelet count would be normal here.
In von Willebrand's disease, there is deficiency of von Willebrand factor. This von Willebrand factor mainly helps to facilitate addition of platelets to endothelial cells when exposed to an injury, and also helps to stabilize factor 8. As there is deficiency of this von Willebrand factor, there is continuous bleeding. So in this, there is prolonged BT, APTT, and normal PT and platelet counts can be seen. In Bernard-Soulier syndrome, there is deficiency of glycoprotein 1B, which is a receptor of von Willebrand factor. Hence, platelets do not aggregate, bleeding time is prolonged. So, there is prolonged bleeding time and normal PT and APTT. Then, coming to hemophilia A. In hemophilia A, there is deficiency of factor 8. And in hemophilia B, there is deficiency of factor 9. So both comes under intrinsic pathway. So there is prolonged APTT and normal PT and platelet count. In liver diseases, see, like, coagulation factors are produced in the liver. As there is a liver damage, these coagulation factors are not produced here. Hence, there is prolonged PT, APTT, BT and platelet count. In DIC, that is disseminated intravascular coagulation, which is a consumptive coagulopathy, there is since the coagulation factors and platelets are consumed and forms disseminated clots here, hence there is abnormal PT, APTT, BT and platelet count. And in fibrinogen deficiency, there is prolonged TT.
Thrombin type.
Factor 5 and factor 10 comes under common pathway. So, in the deficiency of factor 5, factor 10, vitamin K and warfarin therapy, there is prolonged PT, APTT with unaffected BT and platelet count.
Thank you.
If you feel this video is informative, like it,
share with your friends,
and subscribe for more updates.